We are to begin recording right now. There we go. Conference line.
To stop conference recording, press 1. To return to the conference, press *.
Nice. Let us pray. Dear Father, we come into this high service with great expectation. I am expecting a dislodging of territorial inconvenient forces in the heavenlies, in the water, on the earth. We light a light for you to represent that you are light, and with you there is no darkness. Therefore, carefully you have planned this service to do things that no human being ever thought of. Father, you have planned to deliver people during this second phase of our ministry this year, more than I've ever seen it. You have called me and empowered me and chose me to go and preach the gospel to the nations, to capture nations, cities, states, towns for you, people, groups, families, to overthrow. You said you are going to disorganize things that have been organized against humanity. Therefore, today, you will show your power, Jesus. You will show the world that you are the Son of the Living God, and that Baal, the son of darkness, has no chance. Therefore, patiently, we wait and we call you to show up, Jesus. Walk into this service, show up. Holy Spirit, show up more than you've ever showed up anywhere Dear Father, show up. I order and command that angels of breakthroughs be released. Let the north wind, the south wind, the east wind, the west wind receive the presence of God. Let angels begin to move from one end of the earth to another on assignment. Our world is not going to remain the same. And we will not continue to tolerate the nonsense from the kingdom of darkness. For we are sons of light. And light has come into the world, and darkness cannot overcome it. Because him who said, let there be light, light tore through the darkness, and darkness fled. Everyone on the conference line, on your stream, everyone watching from around the world, unmute your phone and begin to shout, let there be light. Let there be light. Jesus is the light of the world. Begin to shout, let there be light. And let everything that has been hidden against you be exposed. We are not joking here today.
Let there be light. Let there be light.
Let there be light.
Everything hidden against
us. Everything
is in the dark. Everything is in
the dark.
Let there be light in your name.
Geneva, go ahead and read the reading for this afternoon. This is a very, very important service.
Okay. Have you turned off the music, please?
Okay. Go ahead.
Okay, we have 1 Kings 18:1-40. After a long time, in the third year, the word of the Lord came to Elijah. Go and present yourself to Ahab. I will send rain on the land. So Elijah presents himself to Ahab. Now the famine was severe in Samaria, and Ahab had summoned Obadiah, his palace administrator. Obadiah was a devout believer in the Lord. While Jezebel was killing off the Lord's prophets, Obadiah had taken 100 prophets and hidden them in 2 caves, 50 in each, and had supplied them with food and water. Ahab had said to Obadiah, go through the land to all the springs and valleys. Maybe we can find some grass to keep the horses and the mules alive, so we will not have to kill any of our animals. So they divided the land they were to cover, Ahab going in one direction and Obadiah in another. As Obadiah was walking along, Elijah met him. Obadiah recognized him, bowed down to the ground, and said, is it really you, my lord Elijah? Yes, he replied. Go tell your master, Elijah is here. What have I done wrong? that you are handing your servant over to Ahab to be put to death. As surely as the Lord your God lives, there is not a nation or kingdom where my master has not sent someone to look for you. And whenever a nation or kingdom claimed you were not there, he made them swear they could not find you. But now you tell me to go to my master and say, Elijah is here. I don't know where the Spirit of the Lord may carry you when I leave you. If I go and tell Ahab and he doesn't find you, he will kill me. Yes, I, your servant, have worshipped the Lord since my youth. Haven't you heard, my Lord, what I did while Jezebel was killing the prophets of the Lord? I hid 100 of the Lord's prophets in 2 caves, 50 in each, and supplied them with food and water. And now you tell me to go to my master and say Elijah is here? He will kill me. Elijah said, as the Lord Almighty lives, whom I serve, I will surely present myself to Ahab today. So Obadiah went to meet Ahab and told him. And Ahab went to meet Elijah. When he saw Elijah, he said to him, is that you, you troubler of Israel? I have not made trouble for Israel, Elijah replied. But you and your father's family have. You have abandoned the Lord's commands and have followed the Baal. Now summon the people from all over Israel to meet me on Mount Carmel and bring the 450 prophets of Baal and the 400 prophets of Asherah who eat at Jezebel's table. So Ahab sent word throughout all Israel and assembled the prophets on Mount Carmel. Elijah went before the people and said, how long will you waver between two opinions? If the Lord is God, follow him. But if Baal is God, follow him. But the people said nothing. Then Elijah said to them, I am the only one of the prophets left, but Baal has 450 prophets. Get two bulls for us. Let Baal's prophets choose one for themselves and let them cut it into pieces and put it under wood, but not set fire to it. I will prepare the other bull and put it under wood, but not set fire to it. Then you call on the name of your God, and I will call on the name of the Lord. The God who answers by fire, he is God. Then all the people said, what you say is good. Elijah said to the prophet of Baal, choose one of the bulls and prepare it first. Since there are so many of you, call on the name of your God, but do not light the fire. So they took the bull given them and prepared it. Then they called on the name of Baal from morning till noon. Baal, answer us! They shouted, but there was no response. No one answered, and they danced around the altar they had made. At noon, Elijah began to taunt them. Surely, he said, surely he is God. For as he is deep in thought, or busy, or traveling, when he is sleeping and must be awakened. So they shouted louder and slashed themselves with swords and spears, as was their custom, until their blood flowed. Midday passed, and they continued their frantic prophesying until the time for the evening sacrifice. But there was no response, no one answered, no one paid attention. Then Elijah said to all the people, come here to me. They came to him, and he repaired the altar of the Lord, which had been torn down. Elijah took 12 stones, one for each of the tribes descended from Jacob, to whom the word of the Lord had come, saying, your name shall be Israel. With the stones he built an altar in the name of the Lord, and he dug a trench around it large enough to hold 2 shades of seed. He arranged the wood, cut the bull into pieces, and laid it on the wood. Then he said to them, fill 4 large jars with water and pour it on the offering and on the wood. Do it again, he said, and they did it again. Do it a third time, he ordered, and they did it the third time. The water ran around the altar and even filled the trench. At the time of sacrifice, the prophet Elijah stepped forward and prayed, Lord, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Israel, let it be known today that you are God in Israel and that I am your servant and have done all these things at your command. Answer me, Lord. Answer me. So these people will know that you, Lord, are God, and that you are turning their hearts back again. Then the fire of the Lord fell and burned up the sacrifice, the wood, the stone, and the soil, and also licked up the water in the trench. When all the people saw this, they fell prostrate and cried, "The Lord is God! The Lord is God!" Then Elijah commanded them, "Seize the prophets of Baal. Don't let anyone get away." They seized them, and Elijah had them brought down to Kishon Valley and slaughtered there. That's it.
Come and read to us Ephesians.
Ephesians chapter 6, verse 12. For we do not wrestle against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of darkness of this age, against spiritual hosts of wickedness in heavenly places. That's it.
Thank you. This afternoon, God is going to deliver you. This afternoon is total deliverance from Baal. We had a service like this some months ago. I think it was when I moved down to this side. I don't remember whether it was when I moved down here or the other side, when I was living at the other side. But we had such a service. But for some reason, I have to remove it. Please, if you have your kids around you, could you mute your phone? Please mute your phone. There is somebody, you have your kids around. When I will need people to pray together, then you can unmute. So if you are at your job, if you have other things you are doing that you know will create some noise, please mute your phone. When I will need people to pray, I will ask you to do so that you can unmute your phone and pray along. Before you unmute your phone, I want everybody to open their phone. I want you to begin to pray. I want you to begin to ask God to be present. I want you to ask God's power to be here. I want you to bind all demonic forces right now. Spirit of envy, spirit of jealousy, spirit of poverty, spirit of competition, spirit of harassment, embarrassment, spirit of complication, spirit that do not want you to concentrate and receive from God. Bind them now. This afternoon is total deliverance on Baal. Ask God that in any way, if Baal has been ruling your life and family, your job, that you want to be delivered totally right now.
I'm going to go back to the hospital.
Tell God to break the spirit of deceit, wickedness, and lying spirit. Those are Baal, lying spirit, spirit of wickedness. Spirit of deceit, manipulation. These are all Baal's work. Spirit of idolatry, spirit of immorality, spirit of poverty and suffering. They are all from Baal. Tell God that you are willing to be delivered totally from this minute. Begin to pray. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. One of the strongest spirits you are going to pray against, in which Baal normally manifests. This is one of the ways you're going to know that Baal is manifesting in your life. It is what we call the spirit of the adversary. Adversary means people rise up against you. Baal enters people and use them against you. So at any time you're asking God for something, instead of you receiving, let's say you're asking God for a Mercedes Benz or a Jaguar or a BMW, or you're asking God, like I know of a lady who is asking God for a Range Rover. So instead of you receiving exactly what you're asking God, you will receive something less than that. Idika Imeri Ministry. Hello? So you're asking God for one thing. Instead of you receiving exactly what you are asking for so that you can enjoy it, instead you receive inferior thing. You're asking God for a husband. Instead of receiving a husband, you receive a monkey or a donkey.
Hello.
See that? You're asking God for a marriage. Instead of receiving a marriage, you receive a mockery. Instead of receiving, asking God for, you ask God for happiness. Instead, you receive abuse. Always there will be somebody on the highway in the dark planet that will say, look at that Christian. She's not praying. She doesn't understand how this game is done. And they tweak it. There's always somebody, you get a new job, there's always somebody, like somebody has been placed before you even wrote your application for that job. It's like somebody was already placed before you arrived to oppose you. The spirit of adversary shows up as opposition in everything you want to do. That's what we call an adversary. Somebody that opposes that something good happens to you. That is why you work so hard. Many of you put in so many hours. If somebody asks you where is the money, you have no idea. Because there is an adversary. There is opposition. Now, let me tell you another way that Baal shows up. Baal shows up by bringing you the wrong kind of people. And let me tell you how this works. Let me begin by sharing with you who Baal is. Baal is the spokesperson. He's the right hand. He is the general, the spokesperson, the administrator of Lucifer, of that world, of that, if we want to call it, let be specific, if we want to call it their own little kingdom. He's the spokesperson. Just as you have, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, whereby Jesus is the mouthpiece of God. Everything that God says goes into Jesus. Jesus carries God the Father with him. He carries out the order of God the Father. Whatever God the Father is the one that brings an idea. And Jesus is the one that carries out, that administers the policies of God. He is the one that implements them. The one that tells everybody else the will of the Father. Is always in Christ or through Christ. You can never receive anything of God except through Jesus. Never.
Excuse me.
There is no good thing of God that will ever come your way except through Jesus. Even the Holy Ghost, you ask Jesus to baptize you with the Holy Ghost. That's what John the Baptist says, John the announcer. That Jesus is the one that baptizes with the Holy Spirit and fire. So you ask him, then he releases the Holy Spirit. Then he asks the Father, and then he comes to you. He is the administrator of everything. You want the presence of the Father? Go to Jesus. Listen to this. In the same way, the administrator, the mouthpiece, the power of Satan, the adversary of Lucifer, the fallen archangel that used to be in the presence of God, which is a warning for all of us, that you can eat and dine with God, but that will not stop God from throwing you out. If you become diabolical, you begin to imagine bad things to do, God will throw you out. That's what he did. And also he will overthrow everyone that follows you. Because that's what happened to the demons. The demons used to be a civilization on earth. They were the ones who were here before us. But because they followed Lucifer, God overthrew them too. Yes, my brother. Keep on singing so that they will not be blind. Yes, he is the sign. So listen carefully to what I'm telling you this afternoon, because it's very, very important. If you understand this mystery and mastery and secrecy of the supernatural, there's nothing you cannot overcome. That's why I removed the former video on deliverance from Baal. And I said, I'm going to spend time to ask God to do it right, to explain this thing very right for you. Whatever Satan wants to do, he does it through Baal. Baal is called the son of Satan. He is his right-hand man, his immediate person who works with him. He takes down minutes of the proceeding of every meeting. There is no meeting of Lucifer that Baal is not present. If Baal is not there, the meeting is not going to hold until he comes. And then he is the policy implementer. He stays there, he sees, he knows what happened in every witchcraft circle. Every occultic, astrological, divination, healing through dark means, progress and money through dark means. Every human sacrifice is murder. Every morality and idolatry, he is behind it all. And then now let me begin to explain. Baal, I'm not sure whether Baal is a fallen archangel or not, but I will say that he falls into that category, because you cannot be the devil right-hand man without having been an archangel cherub. There will be no way. You must have been a fallen archangel for you to feel that big shoe that he feels. The same thing with Leviathan. I am persuaded to believe that both Leviathan, Lucifer, and Baal are all fallen archangels. That's why they wield mighty powers of darkness for those who want that kind of power. Baal has been presenting himself. He has been making himself known. He is not a hidden creature. I was ministering to a lady in England. As I was about to finish ministering, something told me there is Baal in this woman. So I erupted right here in Wichita, Kansas, over the means of communication we were using. I erupted on this side and I said, "Baal, come out!" Next thing I hear from the voice of this woman was, "Oh, so you found me out." I said, "Sure I do." Then Baal asked me, "Why do you want this woman to be delivered?" "This woman have been in my service for a long time." I said, "Are you serious?" He said, "Yes." I said, "Tell me more." And Baal began to talk with me. Next thing I knew, Baal called me by my first and last name, showing me the way he pronounced my last name, showed me he has always been present in my family line. Because there is no family in the face of the universe. There is no family in the face of the earth that Jesus is not involved with. And there is no family in the face of this earth that Baal is not involved in one form or another in the family line. There is none. He instigates people to do things. He enters and influences people to do things. He sends demons to enter people and make them do things. The two easiest way he influences culture. Every culture, Baal is present. Just as people go to the Father through Jesus, through his crucifixion, his suffering. I mean, real suffering. The Son of God really suffered brutal death as a human being. Suffered. If you hear the yelling, the moaning, the crying of Jesus when he was being crucified, you will never mess with him. Recently, he has been talking to me about his crucifixion, and he was telling me what to do about his crucifixion. I'm not releasing that information to anybody, because he told me where the power of my ministry is gonna be in the next level. Just last night, Christ Jesus came to my bedroom and told me something about himself that is gonna be where the power is going to be the secret of the power of God in me for the next level of my ministry. And he told me exactly what to do each day concerning his suffering, his crucifixion, his death, and his resurrection. There's no book written on earth about that kind of stuff. So begin to listen to what I'm going to tell you. People are connected to God the Father through Jesus by the power of the Holy Spirit. People are connected to Satan, to Lucifer, because Satan wants to be worshipped. That's the real thing. Just as God the Father is worshipped, Satan wanted to be worshipped. And all the fallen angels and archangels, etc., and fallen creatures worship Satan. Get it from me. They worship Lucifer. Demons worship Lucifer. Witches worship demons, who in turn worship Baal, who in turn they all worship Lucifer. So get it from me. What is going on here? This is not a small thing. People are connected to Lucifer through Baal by the power of Leviathan, the dragon of the sea. The power, the spirit of Lucifer that is at work in today's world comes from the sea. That's why the strongest strongholds of darkness is the water world. Someone should remind me to teach about the water world. You guys need to know what is happening there. The water is not just an empty place full of fishes and whales and dolphins. There is more in the water world. And many a times when you see problems in the water, a plane crashing in, ships crashing in, somebody wants blood. That's why you have to take Christianity serious, so that you will not be sacrificed to Lucifer. Jesus has already sacrificed himself to the Father. You do not need to be a sacrifice that witches and people in your families or outside your families will or have already sacrificed, and you are just a walking zombie. And today, totally, God will deliver you. Leviathan is the spirit that enters children of darkness, wicked and evil people on earth, in order to connect them to Baal. And from Baal, the stronghold is strong. The trinity of darkness is strong over their lives. That's why we call it a stronghold. And none of this trinity of darkness, Lucifer, Baal, or Leviathan, was ever born by a human mother. That is where God is ahead of them. You see, they are not flesh and blood. They are spirit beings. But that doesn't mean that they cannot turn to humans. That doesn't mean that they cannot sleep with human women. They do it. They've done it before. And that's the reason why the world of Noah's time was destroyed, because of the mixture of human seed with devilish seeds. And what kind of seed do you think will enter a woman through demons? That's why we have to be careful, because those of you who goes to devils to ask for children, who goes to the devil, to astrologers, diviners, witch doctors, voodoo, all these dark practices, you go anywhere in the world to look for children, to look for a husband to marry, your wife to marry, to look for money, for progress, for star, for your face to shine, for favor and fortune, be careful. Because the children that will be given to you when you go to ask for those things are not going to be correct children. The wife and the husband you're going to get through them, through Baal, is not going to be the right one. It means that you have tithed, you have completely sold, surrendered entire generations for many, 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 many years to come to Lucifer through Baal. Now, Baal has his hand in every culture of the world, no matter how civilized it is, he's there. Intellectual world, banking industry, legal industry, immigration, the tax, the construction, all kind of engineering, entertainment, whoa, he's there big time. Dancing, music, poetry, two important ways that he manifests very easily through Leviathan, I mean Baal, is through idolatry. That is the worship of other gods outside the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Outside Jesus, the Holy Ghost, and God the Father, anything that makes you to deviate from the worship of the one true God, Father, our Lord and God, and Jesus, our King, and the Holy Spirit, our leader, is idol worship. He manifests easily as idol spirit, the spirit of idolatry. He also manifests very easily as the spirit of fornication and immorality, whereby people do those things to get money. So if you find yourself in a situation that you enter into a marriage with somebody because of things, material resources and money, or there is fornication and immorality, adultery, a marriage is going on very, very well, Baal will bring a man into that relationship, maybe a friend of the husband. And when the husband is not around, the friend will come in to have sex with the wife and ruin the marriage. Baal is always asking for one person to use. Leviathan will go into that person, and that person will go in and do things in these two areas. Will lead you into worshiping idols. For example, idols is not just when people make things of wood to worship. Idols could be your television. Idols could be your pizza, your Coca-Cola or Pepsi, gambling, all forms of addiction. That becomes your idol because they take the place of God. You don't pray, you don't read scripture, you don't pray in spirit, you don't want God, you curse God. Little things that happen, you are so anxious, fearful, doubtful, unbelief. Fear, doubt, unbelief, worry are signs of Baal in that territory or in your life or in your family. If you find yourself attracted to psychics, astrologers, to people who practices the things of, that's why many of you are attracted to false prophets and false prophetess, false apostles, false pastors, false evangelists, false healers. Why? Because of what we call the law of attraction. Baal carries with him the power of law of attraction in the way of darkness. So this is how it works. You see, if in your bloodline there is idol worship and practice of witchcraft or practice of the occult of any kind, Baal will make sure that the man you marry or the woman you marry also come from a family where they practice that kind of thing. If there have been failed marriages in either your father's side or your mother's side, Baal will want to connect you with a man or woman through whom the marriage between both of you will fail or the business will collapse. See, that's the law of attraction. That's why many of you are attracted to people that appear very nice and sweet and innocent, very wealthy and good, but when you get attached to them, when you become attracted to them and you marry them or begin to do business with them, that thing begin to collapse. Why? That was the very reason why you were put together with them. He will never hook you up with somebody who is coming to make your life better. It will be somebody who will come to make the strongholds to continue to work. It will be somebody who will help to make the ridicule, the mockery, the embarrassment, the confusion, the anxiety, the worry, the doubt, the unbelief to continue to work. It will be somebody who come to screw your life up so bad, to abuse you and to beat you and to rape you, just as it has been in one side of your family or the other. That is what we call the law of negative attraction. The person who carries it with him is Baal. Haha. You are getting more than you saw in the first video that I deleted. You will never be allowed to enter into anywhere where you will progress, or where you will drink water in peace, or where you will progress in peace without nothing blocking you or opposing you. There will always be an opposition. And he will always bring you in connection with people who have the same kind of spirit you are afraid of, and they will begin to manifest it. I want you to begin to think about what I'm saying. Baal is known as the god with a thousand faces. Baal is the god with a thousand faces. The reason is because he appeared under different ways, different means, different names in different culture, but in the same person. That's why he is a deceiver. Just as Satan is a deceiver, he is a liar, a manipulator. Just like Satan, Lucifer is a liar and a manipulator, like father, like son. So the same bell that is working in your village or in your city is the same bell that is working in my own. The reason is the occupation of the atmospheric position. That is why God wants you to occupy territories, to take over nations. Because if you don't, now, the word there is not just occupy. The word there is to rule. It's not to lead. It is to rule. Fallen angels and demons do not lead. They rule. God is calling you to rule. If you are not willing to rule, Baal will make sure, one way or the other, he begins to rule and influence your life and territory. And whatever power is strongest in your nation or strongest in your territory, you fall under it. And that is why two ways that Baal influenced Israeli culture was through idol worship and through immorality, rebellion against God, and the explosion of the spirit of wickedness, spirit of control and destruction. And will make people not to have no fear of the living God, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. You will have no fear. You will kill without no remorse, no pity. Every killing that has been happening on the earth outside the death of Jesus is a sacrifice to Lucifer and to Baal and to all the demons who want worship. Who do you think, when people sacrifice human beings, who do you think they are sacrificing it to? Baal has been doing a good job from long before humans, we came to this earth, long before it. And when God made us, he and Lucifer and Leviathan then decided that they are going to be in competition and in alliance with humanities. And that is the fight that has been going on. It's the two sides trying, the two sides allowing us to make a choice between both sides. So the thing we read in 1 Kings 18, 1 to 40, how a woman actually was in charge, even though there was a king, Ahab. And they were following Baal. So Baal is not just that some humans, you know, when you begin to research Baal, you begin to research ancient gods and goddesses, you see people want to dismiss it. Oh, some kings make themselves into a Baal or a Baalim. Baal also, let me share this with you, Baal also expresses himself as female or male. After all, why not? The reason is this. Baal claims ownership over people. The greatest interest of Baal is L-O-R-O-D, to be a lord, owner over families. Especially, he is interested in families. Listen to me. He is interested in who comes into the family and who gets out of it. Think about that. He's interested who does business in the family and who does not. The reason is this. Baal, either showing himself as male or female, becomes a mistress over a man, over a human male, and become a husband over a female. I can assure you of this. Every human born into certain families, Baal will be married to each and every one of them. Get it from me. The greatest interest of Baal is to be married. Shut up! Okay? I'm talking. You have no say here. Yes, I know. You are afraid that your kingdom is being shaken because you don't like people to talk about you. So shut up and listen, because it is going to be shaken. So let me continue what I'm talking about. Baal is a very secret person that also walked very openly with Leviathan. And this is how it goes. His greatest desire is to be married, is to marry everyone born into a family. He want to wed all people, male and female. That's why you see the same thing that is running in this woman, in this family, is running in the other person. That's why family seems to have the same characteristics. Let me tell you something. There are certain cultural display among the Calabar people of Nigeria. It is called Egbe. Egbe means lion. It's a lion play. It's a cultural dance, but it's more than culture. It is connected with the world of witchcraft, world of the Ndems. Ndems means the mermaids, the water world. That is Leviathan. It is connected with the eye, the one eye of darkness that is watching over cultures, watching over what is happening in every sector of human endeavors. And that's why our job this afternoon is to take back our world, is to take back our lives, take back our money. That's why the banking industry collapsed, the housing industry collapsed, because he made them collapse. Our job is to take back all these sectors. That's why when Jesus said to Christians, study banking, study finance, study marketing, study how to raise animals, how to raise crops, be a farmer. Be a farmer, be a businessman, be this, be that. is so that he can rule the earth through you. Because a lot of Christians have given this up. You go into a company, it's all filled with people in the occult. And they all know themselves. Do not allow BAAL to continue to marry your family. That's why, as a young person, you are sleeping in the night, you begin to see somebody coming to have sex with you. You don't know who it is. You begin to see vampires come to scratch your body. You wake up in the morning, you see real long claws on your skin. Where do this? You see some on your butt, some on your back, some on your belly. Where are these coming from? Sweetheart, you are married to somebody in the supernatural realm. And that's why nobody wants to marry you in the physical. And any marriage you enter into, somebody come and trash it and destroy it. Why? Because you already married to that person a long time ago. Yet there is something like being married to the powers of darkness. Yes, there is. If you're a pastor and you don't know this, oh my goodness, why are you in ministry? Let me share something with you. There is a lot of progress in the world that does not come from God, that comes from the other side. If you refuse to be married to the power of BAAL, your business begins to collapse. They sack you from your job. They terminate you. Until you go and reconcile with God, you begin to look at the history of your family and say, where have we been involved in idol worship, immorality? Where have we shedded blood? Tell lies against people. All kind of stuff. And you begin to look at those and begin to repent and begin to ask God to marry you off to Jesus Christ. See, the way God does it is the way they try to do it in their own side. Jesus wants to be married to all of us. To be a husband to all of us. And BAAL want to do the same thing. That's what BAAL has been doing since ancient time. Wherever the power of God shows up, the anointed one of darkness comes to come and sabotage it. Wherever there is a progress from God, he comes to sabotage it. And a lot of Christians do not know this. So I'm pleading with you today. I am not here to give you long research about BAAL. What I come to do is to tell you the practical things that will solve your problem. That's what I'm after. I'm not here for intellectual things. Some people, when they see my videos and the teaching and my services, and they know that I used to be a professor, they want to engage me in intellectual thinking and things. I said, that's not why I'm here. That's not why I'm here. I am here to solve your problems. That's why I'm here. So I'm asking you this afternoon to begin to ask God, tell God I'm willing to be delivered this afternoon. Now, when you pray that prayer, I want you to tell God this. Open the phone line and begin to tell God this. Tell God, I don't know what has happened in my family, but if you know what has already happened in your family, reveal it to God. Unmute the phone, begin to talk to God, but if you do not know what has happened in the family, but you see things happening around you that doesn't allow you to progress, I want you to begin to tell God, if there have been bloodshed in my family, forgive. If there have been immorality, forgive. If there have been idol worship, forgive. If people have consulted darkness, forgive. I stand here. If there have been lying in the family, forgive. All kind of stuff, forgive. As you pray that prayer, I will begin to speak a word over the communion. And I'm going to marry you off to Christ Jesus this afternoon. I'm going to lay my hand on the bread and the wine, and I will proclaim an absolute and total deliverance from BAAL for you. Before then, I'll begin to shout and holler. So begin to pray. Begin to pray. Unmute the phone. Ask God to deliver you. Shout at Bell. Tell Bell to quit his hold over your life. Tell Bell that you have nothing to do with him anymore. He should get out of your life and quit being a hindrance to your life. Begin to plead the blood. Begin to pray. Begin to tell him that you have nothing to do with him and that you are divorced from him forever. Begin to pray. Come on, begin to pray. Let your spirit come upon this bread. Oh Lord, make it holy by the power of your spirit. Let your spirit come upon this wine to make it holy. That it will become for us a sharing in the blood of Jesus. And Father, and this bread are sharing in the body of Christ, and the blood are sharing in the blood of Jesus. Thank you, Lord God. On the night in which Jesus gave himself for us, on that Monday, Thursday night in which Jesus gave himself for us, he took this bread, he gave thanks, broke it, gave to his disciples, said, "This is my body broken for you. Do this in memory of me." Lord, with this bread, we unite ourselves with thee. We are one with you from now on. And Lord, we are delivered from the power of Baal totally. After supper, he took the cup. He gave thanks and gave it to his disciples and said, "This cup, the new covenant in my blood, a new covenant has been established. Therefore, Baal has no power over us. We are delivered from the power and the influence of Baal in our family, in our cultures, in our territories forever." Father, I know that there is going to be a rumble in the water world. There is a rumble already in the atmosphere, and there will be a rumble on the earth to show his anger. Who cares? Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you that no life will be lost. We rebuke tornadoes, hurricanes, tsunamis. We rebuke volcanic eruption and earthquakes. We rebuke high-powered winds and violence. We rebuke all manners of destruction, all manners of air crashes, all manners of sea crashes, all manners of accident on the road, all manners of sickness. We bind, we take authority that they will not happen. Because what we are doing is a new covenant, and your covenant of your blood surpasses everything. The reason is this: we are not just praying to a God who is just spirit. Jesus, you are also our flesh and our blood. Because of it, you have the strongest power. So we thank you and we worship you. Father, with this blessing, with this announcement, organization, and propagation of new covenant and life, I bring everyone who will watch this video and everyone who are on the conference call this afternoon, I bring them, O God, under your authority and under your influence and power. I marry them. I wed each and every one of us to Christ Jesus. I sever every relationship. I sever and destroy and divorce you, BAAL. Get out right now. We destroy your hold over our cultures. We destroy your hold over families and individuals. We destroy them in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Father, in every planet and in every realm, in every sphere, we destroy the stronghold of BAAL and Lucifer and Leviathan over our lives, both now and forever. Amen and amen and amen. You are in the world, I want you to begin to pray in tongues. Wherever you are in the world, begin to pray in the spirit. Begin to pray in tongues. Begin to pray in tongues. Begin to pray in spirit. Begin to pray in the spirit. Begin to pray in the spirit. Begin to pray in the spirit. Everybody, begin to fight for your life. Begin to fight for your life. Begin to fight for your family. Begin to fight for your existence. Begin to fight for your life. Every one of you. Okay, did you hear that? And that is true. Begin to fight for your life. A lot of Christians take it, thank you, Lord, for angels. Thank you, Lord, for the angels who are right here. See what God is saying? You think that this is just a small thing? The fight has been won for you. Open your mouth and begin to pray and fight for your life and fight for your job and fight for your family. Fight for your money. Fight for your existence. There is somebody who doesn't want you to be here because you are in the camp of God. Your existence is at stake. Begin to fight for your life. Come on, begin to pray. Begin to pray. Eternal Father, we bring down the worship of Lucifer. We destroy his activities. We destroy his works. Thank you for opening doors for the preaching of the gospel in my life and ministry from nation to nations. Thank you, Lord God. Thank you for the activities of your people. Thank you for supplying the spirit. Thank you for supplying the spirit. Thank you for supplying the spirit. Father, we severe the move and the rule and the reigns of Baal this day. We severe them. We command them destroyed over our families. The spirit of the adversary, the spirit of opposition, we destroy them.
Hallelujah. We are coming after you. We are not backing down. We are coming after you. We have brought
Lord, we break the power of
Baal. We are coming after you. We are
over this nation, over every department of government and private entrepreneurship in every nation of the world. Break the power. We break it now. 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 We break his marriages. We break his relationship. We destroy every covenant made between us and Baal and Lucifer and Leviathan. We break them in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Dear Father, we hold on to the new covenant, the covenant in the blood of the Lamb. We hold on to his blood, we hold on to his passion, we hold on to his resurrection. We have the upper hand. Father, I release total deliverance over your people. I release total deliverance. Everybody begin to shout the blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus over your family. The blood of Jesus over your life. I plead the blood of Jesus over my family, over my children. The blood of Jesus over my life, over this ministry. The blood of Jesus. Be delivered now. Let new fire begin to happen. I destroy the spirit of wickedness. All that has been stopping you from progressing. All that has been stopping you from getting pregnant. Stopping you from getting married and staying in marriage. Stopping you from getting a job and staying in the job. In Jesus' name, we break it. We break it! I want everybody to begin to shout, I and my family and my bloodline, we are new creation. We are new creation in Christ Jesus. Begin to shout, I am a new creation. I and my bloodline, we are a new creation. I am a new creation, a brand new man. I am a new creation. Father, I destroy the spirit of idol worship, the spirit of immorality. I destroy the spirit of poverty and disease and ignorance. I destroy them this day. Thank you, Lord, for giving us what you've given to us in your body and your blood. Thank you for miracles, signs, and wonders. And now I want you to tell God to begin to pour, tell God to begin to pour his abundance of blessings upon you. If before you do that, let me tell you to do something. If you have your Bible, whether the Bible is in the computer, on your laptop, on your smartphone, I want you to place your hand over that phone. Imagine there is a Bible inside that phone, like my own, there is a Bible in it. If you have a physical Bible, pick it and bring it right now in 1 second. We want to do something really quick. I want you to place your hand over the Bible, and I want you to begin to tell God that every blessing that he's spoken about in the Bible, You want it to be released right now and let it enter your physical body, your mind, and your spirit, and into your bloodline right now. Begin to say every blessing that is in this Bible, begin to run in my bloodline and begin to run in my life. Begin to say it right now. Place your hand on the Bible and begin to command it to happen. Come on!
Every
blessing in this Bible, I command it to become in my life, in my family's life, and my bloodline. Enormous blessing. You come on, those things, and enormous big blessing. You're so kind and wonderful. Dear Father, every blessing that you've spoken over this Bible, I lay my hand on this word of life. I believe, I am willing, and I believe every word written in this Bible is true. Let all the blessings that is in this book that you've spoken enter inside my body, my mind, my spirit, and of members of my family, and begin to produce results immediately in Jesus' name. What is in this book counters everything that Baal has done in my life and in my bloodline and in the life of your people. Lord, every blessing that is in this book enters the life of your people from this day forward. And let the blessing begin to run in their lives, both now and forever. Amen. And amen. And amen. We will have a thought and evening service here at 9 p.m. Central Time. And then we will have the last service for today by 12 midnight Central Time. By 12 midnight. It's going to be amazing. What we have done this afternoon, I've removed the ring of marriage between you and Baal and destroyed them. Please, wherever you are, I want you to say this. If there is any supernatural paperwork or ring or ornament or anything that belongs to Baal, I throw them away. I throw them away in my family and I destroy them. Begin to pray. Father, any ornament, any article of marriage, any article of relationship between me and Baal, and between your people and Baal, between our families, any covenant, I break them and destroy them with the blood of the Son of the Living God, in Jesus' name. Hey, stop. There are some of you who have supernatural things on your bodies. I want each and every one of you lift up your hand to heaven, because I'm going to speak and you're going to see some manifestation right now. Every ornaments of gold and diamonds, every ornaments of silver, every ornaments of marriage and consummation of relationship and covenants that is in your body, on your body, in your house, in your business, wherever, I speak to those ornaments to disappear, to get out of your bodies right now. I command the spirit of Baal to leave you now. Baal, listen to me. Shende yanda kashambarabo. Mendo koshate kayambo. Every covenant based on lies, I break them. Every covenant of lies, manipulation, deceit, go! I break all this covenant and I command every ornament to disappear immediately. Every disease and affliction and suffering and pain and torture that is coming from Baal upon this earth, I bring the death and resurrection of Jesus Christ his blood against their wickedness. You see, many of you believe people and you don't know that they are lying to you. From this day, it will not happen anymore. Father, baptize your people with the real spirit. You will never be led astray by the spirit of Baal, because the spirit of Baal always leads you astray, always leads you to suffering. So from now on, the spirit of God, Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. The spirit of truth, the spirit of the right way, and the spirit of life is entering into each and every one of you. Go home in peace and be bold. And the Almighty God is filling you with new power and new ability from now on and forever. I'll see you guys by 9 p.m. Central Time and also by 12 midnight tonight for the gathering of champions. May the Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, both now and forevermore. Amen and amen. And Jesus has won the battle for you. Amen. Bye-bye. Remember to visit our website. Remember to send in your prayer requests. Remember to go in, send in your donations so that the gospel will be preached. Bye-bye.
Conference recording, press 1. Your conference recording has stopped. The dead with excess arising and pleasing these human eyes, when their hearts are so full of lies and don't value what is inside. Zero limo packaging,
zero limo packaging,
but show me what's in your heart.
Zero limo packaging,
show me what's in your soul.
Zero limo packaging,
ukavalika imbwa mutrausasi kuti ikala muntu. Olo wali esali na nzelu akakamba chizungu ukapaka sauti pa manyua uchi ingala ndiyo ngati uli na gredi neshi ube machamba judge will be see you.
Blessed be our God, but now and forever. Father, bless what we have done today. Rule over your people. Bless your people. Thank you for the works of miracles, signs, and wonders. Lord, we offer you the service we've just done to your glory forever. Bring many sons and daughters to glory and to the knowledge that Jesus is the light of the world. Amen.
Yeah. Neglecting to reach the masses, to please the upper classes, in the name of maintaining spiritual standards.